So we were discussing about Aristotle, right? Aristotle classified animals into red blood animals and non-red blood animals, and he classified plants into, you know, he gave a very basic classification. He classified plants into herbs, shrubs, and trees. Okay, so this was a very basic classification, and then next came Carolus Linnaeus. Okay, Carolus Linnaeus ने binomial nomenclature भी दिया था, हमने last chapter में study किया था. तो Carolus Linnaeus ने बहुत ही simple classification दिया, उसने classify कर दिया organisms को into kingdom plantae and kingdom animalia. Everything we discussed yesterday, right? He classified into kingdom plantae and kingdom animalia. अब इसका ड्रॉबैक क्या था? ड्रॉबैक ये था कि बहुत ज्यादा ऑर्गेनिजम्स की मिक्सिंग हो गई थी, राइट? प्रोकैरियोट्स को यूकैरियोट्स के साथ रख दिया, हेटरोट्रोप्स एंड ऑटोट्रोप्स वर केप्ट टुगेदर, यूनिसेलुलर एंड मल्टी सेलुलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स वर केप्ट टुगेदर, सम लोअर ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट हैव कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ बोथ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स लाइक यूग्लिना. आज के लेक्चर में हम यूग्लिनॉइड्स पढ़ेंगे, ओके? So यूग्लिनॉइड्स पढ़ेंगे. तो यहाँ पे क्या होता है, दे हैव कैरेक्टर्स फॉर बोथ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स. तो इन ऐसे ऑर्गेनिजम्स को, दीज सच ऑर्गेनिजम्स, दे डिड नॉट गेट अ प्रॉपर ग्रुप. यू नो द साइंटिस्ट दे वर कन्फ्यूज. कुछ साइंटिस्ट बोल रहे थे इनको प्लांट किंगडम में रखेंगे, कुछ बोल रहे थे नहीं इनको एनिमल किंगडम में रखना चाहिए. सो सच ऑर्गेनिजम्स दे डिड नॉट गेट अ प्रॉपर ग्रुप. सो दीज वर द ड्रॉबैक्स ऑफ द यू नो द अर्लियर क्लासिफिकेशन विच केम. देयर वॉज अ थ्री किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन ऑल्सो, एंड दिस थ्री किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन, दिस थ्री किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन वॉज गिवन बाय अर्नेस्ट Haeckel. Ernest Haeckel. He added one more kingdom. Kingdom plantae and animalia were already there, right? Plantae tha, animalia tha. He added one more kingdom and he called it protista. Okay, he called it protista. Again, with his classification also, is still the confusion was not clear. You know, again, the photosynthetic and the non-photosynthetic organisms were kept together. Organisms having cell walls, organisms not containing cell walls, they were kept together. So again, it was, you know, kind of not accepted. Then came the four kingdom classification, you know, as we, you know, as the electron microscope was discovered and the scientists, you know, they were able to look, you know, more in detail. They were able to study the structure of the cell in more detail. So four kingdom classification came. The scientist who gave this four kingdom classification was Copeland. Okay, because discovery of microscope हुआ था, तो उसने bacterial cell को, he studied the bacterial cell and he noticed that, you know, it has certain unique properties, तो उसने एक अलग kingdom बना दिया. Okay, he gave another kingdom, he introduced one more kingdom, kingdom Monera. Okay, so four kingdom classification में क्या क्या आ जाएगा? Kingdom Monera, Protista, Plantae, and animalia. Okay, so this is the four kingdom classification which was given by Copeland. The drawback of this classification was fungi. Fungi heterotrophs hote hain, they have a saprophytic parasitic mode of nutrition, but fungi ke paas cell wall hota hai. Okay, so again, fungi, they could not get a proper place, you know, they were still included in plant kingdom, still inke jo characteristics the wo kuch alag the plant se. ठीक है, तो ये इस यू नो द फंगाई इज नॉट गेटिंग अ प्रॉपर प्लेस एंड दे बीइंग केप्ट इन प्लांटे. दिस वाज द ड्रॉबैक ऑफ दिस क्लासिफिकेशन. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज द फाइव किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन, द मोस्ट एक्सेप्टेड क्लासिफिकेशन. ठीक है, जिसके रिस्पेक्ट में हम लोग पूरा चैप्टर डिस्कस करेंगे. आर एच विटेकर वॉज द साइंटिस्ट हु गेव दिस फाइव किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, द नेम ऑफ द साइंटिस्ट, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नाउ आर एच विटेकर, ही यूज्ड फाइव characteristics. The name of these five characteristics, again, very, very, very important. Okay, complexity of the cell structure, whether a organism is a prokaryote or a eukaryote. Now you guys know what is the difference between a prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Kal hum logon ne discuss kiya tha, right? Then complexity of the body structure, whether a organism is unicellular or the organism is multicellular. The next is mode of nutrition. Next is mode of nutrition, whether an organism has autotrophic mode of nutrition or organism has heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so the third character or the third character that he kept in mind was the mode of nutrition, autotrophic or heterotrophic. Then types of reproduction. Then types of reproduction, whether an organism is performing sexual reproduction or asexual reproduction. First chapter में हमने काफी points discuss किए थे asexual और sexual reproduction के बारे में. If you remember, uniparental, biparental and everything, कहाँ पे variation आता है, कहाँ पे gametes का involvement होता है, right? So on that basis also he classified, okay? He kept this point in consideration while making the classification. And the last point, very important point, is phylogenetic relationships. Phylogenetic means evolutionary relationships. Evolutionary relationships. Very important. Okay, so these five points, these five characters, very important, which R.H. Whittaker kept in consideration. Then next, this chart, we discussed this chart yesterday, that it is telling us the direction of the evolution, how Kingdom Monera came, then Kingdom Protista came, and then Kingdom Plantae, Fungi and Animalia, because they're, you know, the exact time of evolution is still not known. So isko hum log saath mein banate hain, theek hai? How the evolution has happened, then which organisms, you know, if we talk about the complexity of the cell, Kingdom Monera here is having the prokaryotes. And then as we move up from Kingdom Monera to Kingdom Protista, it is having eukaryotes. But the eukaryotes which are present here, they are unicellular. Okay, this is very important. We tend to get confused between the organisms which are coming under Kingdom Monera and the organisms under Kingdom Protista. Kingdom Monera, it is prokaryotes. Remember it. This is very important. And Kingdom Protista, it is unicellular eukaryotes. Okay, and then aage multicellular organisms aayenge. Then we are talking about their mode of nutrition. We are talking about their mode of nutrition, autotrophy, heterotrophy, and you know their ecological role, their major ecological role, like plants or the organisms of Kingdom Plantae. Organisms of Kingdom Plantae, they are producers. Then if we talk about fungi, they are mainly decomposers. And the Kingdom Animalia, the organisms of Kingdom Animalia, they are consumers. Very, very important. Okay, this table, we discussed everything in this table yesterday. Star mark, a table directly taken from NCERT, and you know, 100% question comes from here. 100%, you will get one question from this table in your exams, definitely. This is very important. So basically all the characters, you know, which R.H. Whittaker, you know, had taken in consideration. So we are discussing all those characters here. Okay? This is cell type. Monera, I told you, prokaryotes aate hain, and protista, fungi, plantae, animalia. Sab mein kaisa hai? Eukaryotes hai. ठीक है, सेल वॉल. सेल वॉल हियर इज नॉन सेल्युलोजिक इन मोनेरा. इट इज नॉन सेल्युलोजिक इन प्रोटिस्टा. इट मे बी प्रेजेंट इन सम ऑर्गेनिजम्स, इट मे नॉट बी प्रेजेंट इन सम ऑर्गेनिजम्स. इन फंगाई इट इज मेड अप ऑफ अनदर बायोमोलिक्यूल विच इज कॉल्ड एज काइटिन. In case of plants, it is cellulosic, it is made up of cellulose. And in animals, the cell wall is absent. Very important point, a point of differentiation between plants and animals, that animals ke andar jo hai wo cell wall absent hota hai. Then nuclear membrane. Now see, the prokaryotes, they do not have a well defined nucleus, so definitely nuclear membrane absent hoga yahan pe. And protista se sare organisms jo hai wo eukaryotes hai. Eukaryotes, they have a well defined nucleus. So it's very simple, all the organisms of Kingdom Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalia, their nuclear membrane will be present. Body organization, see, monerans, they are prokaryotes, they are bacterias. Okay, so unicellular hote hain, so their body organization will be cellular. Then protista are again unicellular eukaryotes. So again, their body organization is what? Cellular. Now we move on to fungi. There is multicellularity. There is loose tissue formation. Then plantae, again, further evolution, further advancement, tissue and organ level, animalia, tissue, organ and organ system level. And these are the various modes of nutrition that we discussed yesterday: autotrophic, heterotrophic, saprophytic, parasitic. Right, then there is one more classification, the six kingdom classification, which was given by Carl Woese. Basically, he gave the theory of three domains. He gave something higher than the kingdom, so he made the name domains. He gave the theory of three domains. The three domains he gave was archaea, eubacteria and eukaryota. Archaea, it includes, now these are the names of the kingdoms. Okay, these are the names of the kingdoms. He included Archaebacteria. In Eubacteria domain, he included Monera. In Eukaryota domain, Protista, Mycota, Plantae, and Animalia. Mycotas are what? They are fungi. Okay. Next, we started discussing Kingdom Monera, that, you know, Kingdom, the bacteria which are found in Kingdom Monera, they are cosmopolitan, they are found everywhere, hot springs, desert, snow, deep oceans. These are like the extreme habitats, and definitely they are found everywhere else also, right? They are like the most abundant microorganisms. So bacteria are the sole members of Kingdom Monera. Prokaryotes, bacteria, we will discuss about Archaebacteria, we will discuss about Cyanobacteria. Okay, now on the basis of shape, the bacteria, they are classified into four major categories: cocci, bacilli, spirilla, and vibrio. We discussed this yesterday. Cocci is spherical, bacilli is rod shaped. Spirilla, as we can see, spiral, and vibrio, as we can see, this is comma shaped. Okay, so this we discussed yesterday. Then we discussed very important points about Archaebacteria, that Archaebacteria, these are the group of ancient bacteria. Okay, बहुत पुराने टाइम से जो है वो प्रेजेंट है. ग्रुप ऑफ एंशियंट बैक्टीरियाज, राइट? एंड द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द आर्किबैक्टीरिया इज दैट दे आर फाउंड इन सम ऑफ द हार्श हैबिटेट्स, एक्सट्रीम टेम्परेचर, एक्सट्रीम एसिडिक कंडीशंस. ऐसे हैबिटेट्स में जो है वो आर्किबैक्टीरिया मिलेंगे, राइट? वी मेनली डिस्कस्ड अबाउट मेथनोजेंस, देन वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट हैलोफाइल्स, and we discussed about thermoacidophils. So methanogens, they are the methane producing bacteria, right? Methane producing, and normally ruminant animals jo hote hain unke andar bhi milte hain, because their diet is rich in cellulose, so they help in the digestion of the cellulose there. Okay, so methanogens, then halophiles, they are found in extremely salty areas. We wrote example also, Halobacterium and Halococcus. Then acidophils. Thermo means temperature, acido means here acidic environment. So basically they are found at high temperature areas and where the conditions are acidic. Example, hot sulfur springs. Temperature bhi hai, acidic condition bhi hai, hot sulfur springs. Okay, so Archaebacteria, they can be methanogens, halophiles, thermo acidophiles. Theek hai, all this we discussed yesterday. And then Eubacteria ka humne bahut brief mein jo hai wo discuss kiya tha. Right, now Eubacteria, there are thousands of Eubacteria or true bacteria. They are characterized by the presence of rigid cell wall, and if motile, to inke paas ek flagellum hoga, right? Flagellum, it is a locomotory structure. So they are characterized by the Eubacteria, they are characterized by presence of rigid cell wall, and if motile, a flagellum. flagellum. Then cyanobacteria, remember, they are also referred to as blue-green algae. We often get confused because यहाँ पे algae term आता है, तो हम लोगों को लगता है ये plant kingdom में आएगा, thallophytes के अंदर आएगा, ठीक है? So we often get confused. So cyanobacteria, they are only referred to as blue-green algae. Now important point about them is that they have chlorophyll A pigment. Chlorophyll A pigment, which is similar to the green plants. And so if it is similar to the green plants, they are the photosynthetic autotrophs. In the presence of light, they are using light energy to make their own food. And one unique property of cyanobacteria is that they also produce oxygen. They are performing the process of photosynthesis and they are evolving oxygen also. ठीक है, ऑक्सीजनिक फोटोसिंथेसिस करते हैं यहाँ पे, बिकॉज देयर पिगमेंट इज वेरी मच सिमिलर टू द ग्रीन प्लांट्स. एंड इनफैक्ट साइनोबैक्टीरियाज, दे वर द फर्स्ट वंस टू प्रोड्यूस और टू इवॉल्व ऑक्सीजन ऑन अर्थ. जब नेक्स्ट ईयर एवोल्यूशन चैप्टर पढ़ेंगे तब ये वापस पढ़ेंगे कि साइनोबैक्टीरियाज जो थे उन्होंने सबसे पहले ऑक्सीजन प्रोड्यूस करी थी अर्थ पे. ओके, नाउ साइनोबैक्टीरियाज, दे आर यूनिसेलुलर, कोलोनियल और फिलामेंटस, मरीन और टेरेस्ट्रियल. अगैन इट इज टेलिंग आस कि यूनिसेलुलर मिल सकता है या बहुत सारे सेल्स जो हैं दे कैन फॉर्म कॉलोनीज एंड दे कैन स्टे टुगेदर और इट कैन बी फिलामेंटस. ओके, लाइक दिस इज वन ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ नॉस्टॉक. दिस इज वन ऑफ द फिलामेंटस साइनोबैक्टीरिया दैट वी कैन सी. Now colonies, they are generally surrounded by gelatinous sheath and they often form blooms in polluted water bodies. है ना, तुम लोगों ने सुना होगा about a term which is called as eutrophication. In lower classes, this term is very commonly, you know, taught eutrophication. क्योंकि you know जो भी you know waste products होते हैं coming from the factories, they are being released in the water bodies. तो waste जो होता है ना, it is highly rich in the organic compounds and you know nitrogen and phosphorus and all. तो उसकी वजह से क्या होता है, वो water body एक nutrient rich media हो जाता है और वहाँ पे algal bloom हो जाता है. ब्लू ग्रीन एल्गे जो है वो मल्टीप्लाई करके और ग्रो हो जाते हैं एंड इवेंचुअली यू नो ऑक्सीजन डेफिशिएंट हो जाता है वो एरिया एंड वहाँ की जो भी मरीन यू नो मरीन लाइफ होती है दैट स्टार्ट्स टू डिक्लाइन. ओके, सो दे ऑफन फॉर्म ब्लूम इन पोल्यूटेड वाटर बॉडीज. नाउ some of these bacterias they can fix atmospheric nitrogen, right? Hum logo ne padha hai nitrogen cycle, all the you know nitrification and ammonification and all. So there are certain bacterias which can fix the atmospheric nitrogen. Now this atmospheric nitrogen, it is fixed in these specialized structures which are called as heterocysts. Very important, very very important that where does nitrogen fixation take place in blue green algae? It is taking place in specialized structures which is called as heterocyst. And also these heterocysts, they are achlorophyllous. They do not have chlorophyll pigment in them. Okay, so in one first important thing is that they are the sites of nitrogen fixation and second, they are achlorophyllous. Chlorophyll pigment is not present in them. Okay, take a screenshot of this slide and then I will move forward. Okay, I'm moving forward. Next very important part, nutrition in bacteria. So see, bacteria, they show both the types of nutrition, autotrophic as well as heterotrophic. ठीक है, ऑटोट्रॉपिक के अंदर दो टाइप के हो सकते हैं, या तो फोटोसिंथेटिक ऑटोट्रॉप्स हो सकते हैं या और दे कैन बी कीमोसिंथेटिक ऑटोट्रॉप्स. ओके, सो बेसिकली द मीनिंग इज दैट फोटोसिंथेटिक ऑटोट्रॉप्स, दे आर यूजिंग लाइट एनर्जी. Okay, photo term is coming here. Photo. Photo means light. So basically the photosynthetic autotrophs, they are using the light energy for the food synthesis. Okay, and chemosynthetic bacteria, they are oxidizing various inorganic substances such as nitrates, nitrites and ammonia, and are using them to release and use the released energy for their ATP production. Okay, so basically यहाँ पे chemical substances जो हैं they are being used for the production of ATP. Okay, so the difference between chemosynthetic and photosynthetic autotroph is very important. Photosynthetic autotrophs, they are using light energy, and chemosynthetic autotrophs, they are using certain inorganic substances. Okay, now very important point, very important point. हमने ecological role में भी देखा था bacteria के decomposers होते हैं. ठीक है, सो डीकम्पोजिशन से क्या होता है, दे आर बेसिकली यू नो दे आर प्लेइंग अ ग्रेट रोल इन रीसाइक्लिंग ऑफ द न्यूट्रिएंट्स लाइक नाइट्रोजन, फॉस्फोरस, आयन, सल्फर. दीज आर जस्ट सम एग्जांपल्स, राइट. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज, सपोज देयर इज अ डेड ऑर्गेनिक मैटर, एनी प्लांट, एनी एनिमल हैज डाइड. Okay, any plant, any animal has died, and then the decomposing bacterias, the decomposing bacterias, they are going to act on it and they will convert it into certain inorganic compounds, right? They will convert it into certain inorganic compounds like nitrogen, phosphorus, iron, sulfur, okay, etc. Now these are you know, these are present in the soil. So now these compounds, they will be absorbed by the plants, right? Absorption by the plants. Plants are going to obtain them from their from the soil. Then the plants, they will be eaten by the herbivores. Herbivores, they will be eaten by the carnivores, right? And then carnivore will die, herbivore will die, and the plants will also die. So after their death, again, after their death, what? Again, dead organic matter is there. So the decomposing bacteria, they will act on it. So there is this cycle going on, okay? They are basically, you know, recycling the nutrients which are present. So this is very important, that how they are recycling the nutrients. Okay, then next is heterotrophs. Heterotrophic bacteria, they are most abundant in nature. Heterotrophs means they are going to obtain nutrition from some other organism. They can not prepare their own food, and the majority are important decomposers. Okay, they are decomposers. So take a screenshot. If there is some doubt, please put it in the chat box.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, please can you repeat once this chart? You have drawn, yeah. The cycle.
Yeah. I'll just repeat it. Beta, dekho. There is dead organic matter. Where is this dead organic matter coming from? It is coming from the death of carnivores, herbivores, whatever the different organisms that are present. Okay, so this dead organic matter, it is acted upon by decomposing bacteria. Bacteria ko kya karna hai? Isko decompose karna hai. So what they have done, they have converted this complex organic matter into a simpler form, into organic matter. Now this into inorganic compounds. So this inorganic compound is present where? It is present in the soil. Okay, nitrogen, phosphorus, iron, sulfur, all these are the examples. Now these minerals, they will be obtained by the plants again. Plants khud ki growth ke liye, khud ko energy provide karne ke liye, ye sare inorganic compounds ya mineral salts jo hain wo obtain karenge, right? Plant, then this plant, it will be eaten by the herbivores. Herbivores will be eaten by carnivores, and eventually they are going to die. No, plant ki bhi death hogi, herbivore ki bhi death hogi, carnivore ki bhi death hogi. Okay, so that after the death, what will happen again? They are what? They are the dead organic matters. So these are again the decomposing bacteria, they will act on the dead organic matter, and again the cycle is going to begin. Okay, I hope it is clear. Just follow the cycle. Just follow the cycle. यहाँ पे confusion हुआ होगा कि dead organic matter कहाँ से आया. It is coming from the death of these organisms. सबका अपना lifespan होता है ना. आएगा, फिर उसके बाद इसका डेथ हो जाएगा, डेथ के बाद वापस से डेड ऑर्गेनिक मैटर बन गया, इस डेड ऑर्गेनिक मैटर पे डीकम्पोजिंग बैक्टीरिया एक्ट करेगा, इसमें कन्वर्ट करेगा, अगेन इट विल बी टेकन अप बाय द प्लांट्स एंड द साइकिल विल कंटिन्यू. ओके, सो बेसिकली दीज डीकम्पोजिंग बैक्टीरियाज दे आर प्लेइंग अ ग्रेट रोल इन रिसाइकलिंग ऑफ द न्यूट्रिएंट्स, डीकम्पोजिंग बैक्टीरियाज ऑल्सो. एंड अगर तुम्हें नाइट्रोजन साइकिल याद है, if you guys remember nitrogen cycle, the nitrosomonas, the nitrobacter, you know how, if you guys remember how the nitrogen cycle was going on, then also that is also recycling of the nutrients. Okay, so this is about the nutrition in bacteria. Next is bacteria's related to human affairs. So definitely, you know, the bacteria's, they have their uses, but also they are harmful to us. They act as pathogens. They cause certain diseases. Okay, so many of them have a significant impact on human affairs. Like, you know, they help in making curd from the milk. है ना, देखा होगा किचन में, देखा होगा कैसे, यू नो हाउ द कर्ड कैसे हम लोग जमाते हैं, राइट? एवरीवन मस्ट हैव सीन. सो दीज बैक्टीरिया, द स्पेसिफिक बैक्टीरिया दैट इज हेल्पिंग इज लैक्टोबैसिलस. लैक्टोबैसिलस, ओके, लैक्टोबैसिलस लैक्टिस और स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस लैक्टिस. Okay, so curd ke andar conversion of the milk to the curd, this bacteria is helping. Then production of antibiotics. Antibiotics hum log, you know, sab log ne liya hai antibiotics. Antibiotics kya karte hain? Bacterial growth ko jo hai wo stop karte hain, ya fir bacterias ko jo hai wo kill karte hain. Basically antibiotics, they interfere with the metabolism of bacteria. They interfere with metabolism of bacteria. The various cycles, you know, the various metabolic cycles that which are happening in the bacteria, antibiotics unpe act karte hain aur unko kill karte hain. So these antibiotics, you know, some of the antibiotics, they are obtained from bacteria's only. Like for example, streptomycin. Streptomycin, one of the antibiotics which is obtained from the bacteria only. Then fixing of nitrogen in the leguminous root. I gave you the examples, nitrobacter. So these bacteria, they are helping in the nitrogen fixation. Now there are certain pathogens. What is the meaning of pathogens? Pathogens ka matlab hota hai disease causing agents. So some of the bacteria, they also act as pathogens. Animals mein disease cause karte hain, humans ke andar disease cause karte hain, right? Some of the examples are given: cholera, typhoid, tetanus, citrus canker. So cholera is caused by vibrio cholera, hai na? Abhi humne dekha tha shape, vibrio, comma shape. So vibrio cholera, it is a comma shaped bacteria. Typhoid, Salmonella typhi, the causative bacteria, the causative agent or pathogen, kuch bhi bol lo. Typhoid kisse hota hai? Salmonella typhi. Okay, then tetanus hota hai Clostridium tetani. Okay, then there is citrus canker कहाँ पे होता है? Citrus canker crops में होता है, ठीक है? Crops को damage करता है ये, ऐसे नहीं समझ लेना humans में होता है, it is damaging crops, plants का disease है, ठीक है? Cholera तुम लोगों ने सुना होगा, vibrio cholera, typhoid, tetanus and all. Tetanus injection भी लेते हैं हम लोग जब हम, you know, कुछ accident हो जाता है या लग जाती है normally, right? Typhoid, again contaminated food and water. Cholera, ये भी contaminated food and water से होता है. So these are the causative agents. Citrus canker किससे होता है? Citrus canker होता है Xanthomonas citri. This is the name of the bacteria which is causing the citrus canker. Okay, so these are the bacteria which are related to human affairs. Do teen points yahan pe yaad rakhna. Ek to normal, you know, हेल्पफुल होते हैं कुछ बैक्टीरियाज, जैसे दे आर मेकिंग द कर्ड फ्रॉम द मिल्क, देन प्रोडक्शन ऑफ एंटीबायोटिक्स, देन एग्रीकल्चर में जो है वो हेल्प करते हैं बाय फिक्सिंग नाइट्रोजन इन द रूट्स ऑफ द लेग्यूमिनस प्लांट्स, देन देर आर सर्टेन हार्मफुल बैक्टीरियाज दैट आर कॉजिंग द डिजीजेज इन ऑल. तो ये दोनों आस्पेक्ट याद रखना, कुछ जो है वो हेल्पफुल है, कुछ जो है वो हार्मफुल है. ओके, टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट, आई विल मूव ऑन. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज रिप्रोडक्शन इन बैक्टीरिया. सी, रिप्रोडक्शन मेनली अकर्स इन बैक्टीरिया बाय फिजन. फिजन का मतलब क्या होता है? स्प्लिटिंग. सो देयर विल बी one parent cell and it is going to split. It will undergo the process of binary fission, and binary fission is what? It is a method of asexual reproduction, right? Asexual reproduction. So what will happen? One parent cell, it will undergo the process of binary fission, split hoga, and bi means two. So we will get two daughter cells. Okay, we will get two daughter cells. See here in the diagram, a dividing bacteria is given. So how there is this constriction forming, and later on it will divide into daughter cells. Okay, now sometimes under unfavorable conditions they produce by spores. ठीक है, कैसा होता है? बेसिकली जब अनफेवरेबल कंडीशन आता है ना, तो बैक्टीरिया का टारगेट होता है टू सेव इट्स जेनेटिक मटेरियल, बिकॉज जेनेटिक मटेरियल इज द वन विच इज कैरिंग एवरीथिंग, राइट? अनफेवरेबल कंडीशन है, उसको पता है वो सर्वाइव तो नहीं कर पाएगा, सो यू नो इट रिजॉर्ट्स टू सेविंग इट्स जेनेटिक मटीरियल. तो बैक्टीरिया क्या करता है? अपने अंदर एक स्पोर फॉर्मेशन कर लेता है, जेनेटिक मटीरियल को जो है वो उसके अंदर प्रिजर्व कर लेता है. So it does this under unfavorable conditions. Then they also reproduce by a sort of sexual reproduction. See, yahan pe term pe bahut dhyan do. It is already using sort of sexual reproduction by adopting a primitive type of DNA transfer from one bacterium to another. Okay, basically these are, you know, recombination methods. बैक्टीरियाज के अंदर जो है कुछ ऐसे मेथड्स होते हैं, कॉन्जुगेशन, ट्रांसडक्शन एंड ऑल, तो ये उन सब की बात कर रहा है. तो तुम्हें सिर्फ इतना याद रखना है दैट दे ऑल्सो रिप्रोड्यूस बाय सॉर्ट ऑफ सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. एग्जाम में सॉर्ट नहीं लिखा तो जीरो मिलेगा, ठीक है? दे ऑल्सो रिप्रोड्यूस बाय सॉर्ट ऑफ सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन बाय अडोप्टिंग अ प्रिमिटिव टाइप ऑफ डीएनए ट्रांसफर from one bacterium to another. So this is a sort of sexual reproduction. So these are the three important points. These are the three important ways by which a bacteria is going to reproduce. Okay, if you have any doubts, please ask or put it in the chat box and take a screenshot. I will move forward. Okay, next. Mycoplasmas, they also come under kingdom Monera only. Now mycoplasmas, they are the organisms which lack a cell wall. यहाँ पे cell wall जो है वो absent होता है. देखो diagram में देखो, cell wall नहीं है. Instead they have three-layered cell membrane. ठीक है, lipids and proteins से बना हुआ. This is made up of lipids and proteins, or lipoproteins बोल देते हैं. Okay, so there is a three-layered cell membrane. Okay, they completely lack cell wall. They are the smallest living cells known and can survive without oxygen. So if oxygen is not present in the environment, then also these organisms can survive. Many mycoplasmas, they are pathogenic in animals and plants. Pathogenic ka matlab tumhe pata hai, they can cause disease, right? They can cause disease in both animals and plants. And one more important point about mycoplasma is that they are called as jokers of microbiology. जोकर्स ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी क्यों बोलते हैं, देखो इनके पास ना सेल वॉल नहीं है, सेल वॉल नहीं है तो एक रिजिड स्ट्रक्चर नहीं है, स्पेसिफिक शेप नहीं मेंटेन करते, शेप चेंज करते जाते हैं, इसलिए इनका क्या नाम दे दिया, द नेम विच इज गिवन टू देम इज जोकर्स ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. ओके, सो दीज आर द थ्री पॉइंट्स दैट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर अबाउट माइकोप्लाज्मा. माइकोप्लाज्मा भी किंगडम मोनेरा के अंदर ही आ रहे हैं. किंगडम मोनेरा के अंदर हमने आखी बैक्टीरिया पढ़ा है, यू बैक्टीरिया पढ़ा है, साइनो बैक्टीरिया पढ़ा है, माइकोप्लाज्मास पढ़े हैं, ठीक है. एंड देन यू शुड रिमेंबर हाउ द बैक्टीरियाज आर रिप्रोड्यूसिंग, व्हाट इज द मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन एंड देयर रोल, whether you know chahe wo harmful ho chahe wo useful ho, that role slide that we did. Okay, so all these are the few important points that you need to remember from kingdom monera. Okay, take a screenshot. Next we will start with the next kingdom, kingdom protista. Okay, I'm moving forward. Kingdom प्रोटिस्टा. नाउ किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा के अंदर आते हैं यूनिसेल्यूलर यूकैरियोट्स. नाउ इफ यूकैरियोट्स आर कमिंग दैट मींस दे हैव वेल डिफाइंड न्यूक्लियस, राइट, दे हैव वेल डिफाइंड न्यूक्लियस, इनके पास सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स भी होंगे. Right, this is the meaning of eukaryotes. So all the unicellular eukaryotes, they are coming in kingdom protista. All single cell eukaryotes, they are placed under protista, but the boundaries of this kingdom, they are not well defined. Members of protista, they are primarily aquatic. Being eukaryotes, the protistan cell body contains a well defined nucleus and other membrane bound organelles, and some of the protists, they also have flagella and cilia. Okay, locomotory structures hote hain flagella and cilia. So some of the protists, they can have flagella and cilia. Now protists, they reproduce asexually and sexually by a process involving cell fusion and zygote formation. फर्स्ट टाइम सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन जो है वो प्रोटेस्टेंट्स में देखा गया था. बहुत ही बेसिक टाइप ऑफ सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन होता है, सिंपली फ्यूजन ऑफ द सेल्स एंड जायगोट फॉर्मेशन, ठीक है. सो फर्स्ट टाइम सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन प्रोटेस्टेंट्स में देखा गया था. नॉर्मली प्रोटेस्टेंट्स कैसे रिप्रोड्यूस करेंगे, ए सेक्सुअली. सो मोनेरा के अंदर ए सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन था एंड सॉर्ट ऑफ सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन था जहां पे बैक्टीरियाज दे वर ट्रांसफरिंग द जेनेटिक मटीरियल. यहाँ पे दे रिप्रोड्यूस ए सेक्सुअली एंड सेक्सुअली बाय अ प्रोसेस इन्वॉल्विंग सेल फ्यूजन एंड जायगोट फॉर्मेशन. नाउ किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा वी हैव फर्दर डिवाइडेड इट इंटू सर्टन डिविजन्स. हायरार्की याद करो, ठीक है. तो दीज आर द डिविजन्स, क्राइजोफाइट्स, dinoflagellates, euglenoids, slime molds and protozoans. ये सब चीज हम लोग पढ़ेंगे किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा के अंदर, ठीक है. क्राइजोफाइट्स, dinoflagellates, euglenoids, slime molds and protozoans. Very important. You have to remember the names. You have to remember the names that what all is coming under kingdom protista. Rhizophytes, dinoflagellates, euglenoids, slime molds, protozoans. Okay, so now we will discuss these one by one. Okay, so first is rhizophytes. Rhizophytes, this group includes diatoms and golden algae, also called as desmids. Ab ye learn karna hai. Rhizophytes mein diatoms and golden algae aa raha hai. ठीक है, दे आर फाउंड इन फ्रेश वाटर एज वेल एज इन मरीन वाटर. दे आर माइक्रोस्कोपिक, फ्लोट पैसिवली इन द वाटर कारंस. दे आर फ्लोटिंग पैसिवली इन द वाटर कारंस एंड मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर फोटोसिंथेटिक. दे हैव द केपेबिलिटी टू मेक देयर फूड. इन द डायटम्स, नाउ इन द डायटम्स द सेल वॉल्स फॉर्म टू थिन ओवरलैपिंग शेल्स. एवरीबडी मस्ट हैव सीन, यू नो, कैसा हमारा सोप बॉक्स होता है ना, वॉशरूम्स में सोप बॉक्स होता है, उसकी दो लिड्स होती हैं, राइट. ऐसा ही कुछ डायटम्स का भी स्ट्रक्चर होता है. Okay, see, the cell walls, they form two thin overlapping shells which fit together as in a soap box. जैसे soap box को हम अलग करते हैं तो हमारे पास दो shells आ जाते हैं. Similarly, the cell walls of the diatoms, you know, they are they overlap each other, they fit with each other just like the lids of a soap box. Now the walls, they are embedded with silica. This is very important. This is very important. The cell walls, they are embedded with silica. Now, silica is very strong. So, kaisa rehta hai? Jab organisms ki death ho jati hai, still, you know, this large amount of the cell wall, because it has silica, it is indestructible. It remains there. Jahan pe bhi, you know, if they are in the fresh water or in the marine water, wherever this organism was present, once it dies, the cell wall with the silica and all, it is left behind. And it is called as diatomaceous earth. This point is very important. एक तो हमने बात करी कि जो cell wall है, it overlaps just like the, you know, lids of the soap box, and cell walls के अंदर silica particles जो है वो embedded होते हैं, and thus the walls are indestructible. Thus diatoms, they left behind large amount of cell wall deposits in their habitats, and this accumulation over billions of years is referred as diatomaceous earth. Being gritty, this soil, it is used in polishing, filtration of oils and syrups. Then diatoms, they are the chief producers in the ocean. Chief producers, oceans ke andar autotrophic mode of nutrition kare, they are the chief producers in the ocean. Okay, now these are the functions of the diatomaceous earth. Polishing mein help karta hai, filtration of oils and syrups mein help karta hai. It also helps in soundproofing. Soundproof, you know, recording studios बनते हैं या soundproof classrooms वगैरह बनते हैं, वहां पे जो है ये use होता है. Then it is also used as heat insulator. In boilers. Because ये जो diatomaceous earth होता है ना, it is a bad conductor of heat. So if it is a bad conductor of heat, तो simply इसको insulator की तरह use कर सकते हैं. तो बहुत बड़े बड़े जो steam boilers वगैरह होते हैं, वहां पे it is used as a heat insulator. So the functions of diatomaceous earth are very important. ठीक है, again one of the favorite questions. बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ डायएटोमेशियस अर्थ इन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द क्राइजोफाइट्स और द डायएटम्स. तुम्हें ये वाला जो पैराग्राफ है, दिस पैराग्राफ इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. याद रखना है एक तो सोप बॉक्स वाला पॉइंट कि इनके सेल वॉल्स जो होते हैं वो लिड ऑफ द सोप बॉक्स की तरह होते हैं. एंड अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर इज दैट देयर सेल वॉल्स, दे आर एम्बेडेड विद सिलिका. Okay, their cell walls are embedded with silica. That is the another important point that you need to remember. Silica, and silica ki wajah se indestructible hai inki cell walls. Bahut time se deposit hoti chali aa rahi hai inke habitat mein, aur hum usko kya bol rahe hain? Diatomaceous earth. We are calling it as diatomaceous earth. Right? Take a screenshot and then we will move on to the next division. Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Okay, chalo. Screenshot taken. I'm moving forward. Okay, next is dinoflagellates. Very beautiful. Okay, dinoflagellates, they are very beautiful. तुम लोगों ने सुना होगा ये bioluminescence के बारे में, है ना? Bioluminescence. Can you see the image here? How the tide, you know, it is bioluminescent, This bioluminescence is you know, because of these because of the organisms or because of the dinoflagellates. ठीक है, dinoflagellates की वजह से जो है bioluminescence होता है. इनके अंदर ना photogenic granules होते हैं. तो ये जो beautiful सा image दिख रहा है ना तुम्हें, this is because of dinoflagellates. They have photogenic granules, light emit करते हैं वो granules. तो ऐसा हमें appearance दिखता है. ठीक है, dinoflagellates. Now these organisms, they are mostly marine and photosynthetic. They appear yellow, green, brown, blue or red depending upon the main pigments which are present in the cell. क्या इनके main pigments हैं? There are, you know, chlorophyll A, there are xanthophylls, there are carotenoids. These are all the names of the pigments. So कौन सा pigment किसके अंदर ज्यादा present है, depending on that they get their color. So it can be yellow, green, brown, blue or red. Now their cell wall has stiff cellulose plate on the outer surface. See on the diagram, they have a stiff cellulose plate. Now most of them have two flagella. That's why the name here, it is dinoflagellates. Di means two. They have two flagellas. One is lying longitudinally. See, in this diagram, this is the longitudinal flagella, and one is lying transversely. So see, this is the transverse flagella. So two flagellas. One is the longitudinal flagella, and another one is the transverse flagella. Very important. ठीक है, सो वन लाइज लॉन्गिट्यूडिनली एंड द अदर ट्रांसवर्सली इन अ फरो बिटवीन द वॉल प्लेट्स. सी द सेल वॉल, इट हैज स्टिफ सेलुलोज प्लेट्स. इट कैन बी सीन, द प्लेट्स कैन बी सीन, एंड देयर इज वन लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल फ्लैजेलम एंड द अनदर वन इज द ट्रांसवर्स फ्लैजेलम. नाउ वेरी ऑफन red dinoflagellates, example gonioryx, very important. The example is very important. It is the example of red dinoflagellates. They undergo rapid multiplication and they make the sea appear red. ठीक है, red tides. Red tides is also a phenomena which is the result of the rapid multiplication of red dinoflagellate, that is gonioryx. ठीक है, यहाँ पे क्या होता है, दिक्कत हो जाती है, बिकॉज यू नो देयर इज रैपिड मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड इन सच लार्ज नंबर्स यू नो दे आल्सो रिलीज सर्टेन टॉक्सिन्स. ओके, इसे टॉक्सिन्स रिलीज करते हैं जिनको सैक्सी टॉक्सिन बोलते हैं. ओके, दीज सैक्सी टॉक्सिन्स यू नो दे विल डेफिनेटली हार्म द मरीन लाइफ. फिशेज वगैरह को तो हार्म करेंगे ही, ऑल्सो ह्यूमंस तक अगर पहुंच गए, ह्यूमंस तक अगर पहुंच गए फूड चेन से वाया करके, फूड चेन के थ्रू अगर सैक्सी टॉक्सिन्स जो है वो ह्यूमंस तक पहुंच गए, देयर दे कैन कॉज पैरालिसिस. सो दीज टॉक्सिन्स यू नो दे आर क्वाइट हार्मफुल. ठीक है, देन अनदर यूनिक प्रॉपर्टी दैट आई डिस्कस्ड वॉज बायोल्यूमिनेसेंस. वेरी वेरी ब्यूटिफुल एंड अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी, बायोल्यूमिनेसेंस. ओके, बायोल्यूमिनेसेंस, एंड दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ प्रेजेंस ऑफ, ड्यू टू प्रेजेंस ऑफ फोटोजेनिक ग्रैन्यूल्स. After the lecture, you know, you can Google bioluminescence. You'll find beautiful videos, how the tide is coming and how, you know, it is shimmering and, you know, the light can be seen. So it is because of this dinoflagellates. As dinoflagellates are also responsible for this bioluminescence. Mainly, you know, examples, if I'll give you, example is Noctiluca and gonioryx. Okay. These are the examples which cause this bioluminescence. Night light भी बोलते हैं इसको, रात में बहुत beautiful लगता है इसलिए इसको night light भी बोल देते हैं. ठीक है, I hope I'm clear in the dinoflagellates part. Dinoflagellates में तुम्हें दो points बहुत importantly याद रखने हैं structure के बारे में. First is stiff cellulose plates and the two flagellas. One is the longitudinal flagella and another one is the transverse flagella. See, these are all the examples, peridinium, gymnodinium, gonioryx. These are all the examples and we can clearly see here that they have longitudinal flagella and they have transverse flagella. Two flagellas are seen in dinoflagellates. ठीक है, देन रेड टाइड के बारे में याद रखना है, दैट द ऑर्गेनिज्म विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर रेड टाइड. इजी वन मार्कर क्वेश्चन, एमसीक्यू आ सकता है, या मैच द फॉलोइंग आ सकता है. एनी वेज इट कैन कम इजी वन मार्क क्वेश्चन. द ऑर्गेनिज्म विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर रेड टाइड. ओके एंड देन बायोल्यूमिनेसेंस. बायोल्यूमिनेसेंस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नॉक्टिलुका एंड गोनियोलक्स एग्जाम्पल्स याद होते हैं तो कर लेना, अदरवाइज इट्स फाइन. जस्ट रिमेंबर द टर्म बायोल्यूमिनेसेंस, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ठीक है, सो दिस वॉज अबाउट डायनोफ्लैजेलेट्स. टेक अ स्क्रीन शॉट एंड देन आई विल मूव फॉरवर्ड. नेक्स्ट इज यूग्लेनॉइड्स. यूग्लेनॉइड्स ये वही है जिनपे कन्फ्यूजन था. यू नो यूग्लेनॉइड्स आई टोल्ड यू दे हैव द कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ बोथ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स. जिनका मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन होता है इट कैन बी ऑटोट्रोपिक एज वेल एज हेटरोट्रोपिक. तो इसीलिए साइंटिस्ट को बड़ा कन्फ्यूजन हो गया था कि कहाँ पे रखें, बिकॉज यू नो दे हैव दिस फोटोसिंथेटिक एबिलिटी. ओके फोटोसिंथेटिक एबिलिटी है लेकिन इनके पास सेल वॉल नहीं होता है. एनिमल्स से अगर हम कंपेयर करेंगे तो मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन जो है वो एनिमल्स के जैसा है. तो साइंटिस्ट बहुत कंफ्यूज हो गए थे एंड अल्टीमेटली इनको कहाँ पे रख दिया, किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा के अंदर डाल दिया. ठीक है, मेजोरिटी ऑफ देम दे आर फ्रेश वाटर ऑर्गेनिजम्स फाउंड इन स्टैग्नेंट वाटर instead of cell wall. Like I said, cell wall नहीं है. Cell wall की जगह they have a protein rich layer called pellicle which makes their body flexible. See how this euglena is moving. See how it is moving. अगर इसके पास cell wall होता तो वो flexibility जो है वो खत्म हो जाती. Right? इतनी flexibility. See how much flexibility it is showing. So they don't have cell wall. They are very flexible. And this flexibility is because of this protein-rich layer, which is called as pellicle. This pellicle is making their body flexible. So you have to remember, instead of cell wall, they have a protein-rich layer, which is called as pellicle. Now here also, they have two flagella. One is going to be a short one and one is going to be a long one. Again, flagella, it is locomotory. Now, though they are photosynthetic in presence of sunlight, when deprived of sunlight, they behave like heterotrophs by predating on other smaller organisms. Okay. Interestingly, the pigments of euglenoids, they are identical to those present in higher plants. Again, basically, this statement is telling us about the evolution. Okay, it is telling us about the evolution. Euglenoids or the euglena, it is also, you know, considered as a connecting link between plant and animal because it is carrying properties of both plants and animals. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे the important points that you have to remember is instead of cell wall, what is present? Pellicle is present, and this pellicle is providing flexibility. It is providing flexibility. And this point, very, very important. Even though they are photosynthetic, see, we can see chloroplast in them, even though it is photosynthetic, but still if sunlight is not there, it will behave like a heterotroph. It will feed on other small organisms. Okay, so dono properties hoti hai yahan pe. Okay, very important. So these two points, very, very important from euglenoids. Okay, take a screenshot.